Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're going to look at mapping designs onto 3D shapes. I'll start with a brand new document. Mine's just going to be 1920 by 1080 pixels in size in RGB color mode. Yours can be any size you like. Of course, if you're working with an earlier version of Illustrator, your dialogue's going to look something like this. I'm going to go ahead and create my document. Before we can create our 3D shape and map a design onto it, we need the design to work with. So I'm going to make a pattern of stars. I'm going to the star tool. I'm just going to click once in the document. I'm going to create a 5-pointed star. So I'll just click OK. This is a little bit big for me, so I'm just going to shrink it down in size. Right now my star has a white fill and a black stroke. I'm going to get rid of the stroke in a minute, but so that I can see my star while I'm working, I'm going to leave it in place. I'm going to choose Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Transform, because I want a whole heap of stars. So I'm going to type in around 20 as my number of copies, and I'm going to start moving them out in a horizontal direction. So I'm just going to space my stars out nicely. I might add a few extra, just for good measure, and I'll click OK. Now with this star selected, I'm going to choose Effect, Distort and Transform, and Transform again. And I need to apply a new effect. And this time with Preview turned on, I'm going to make about 11 copies, and I'm going to be moving in an upwards direction. So I'm going to be decreasing the vertical value. And this is a nice array of stars for me, so I'll click OK. Now, at the moment, everything is associated with just this star down here, so I need to expand it. So I'll choose Object, Expand Appearance, and then Object Ungroup. And I'll continue to do that until Ungroup is no longer an option. And it's now no longer an option. Now with all of my stars selected, I'm going to turn off the stroke. So I just have a solid filled set of stars. And I'll choose Object and then Group. So now I have a series of white stars all in a group. I'm going to open up my Symbols panel here. If you don't see it, you can choose Window and then Symbols. And you're going to click here on New Symbol. And I'm just going to call this Stars. The fact that it's a dynamic symbol or a static symbol is totally immaterial, and we don't have to reset its export type because that's not appropriate either. We can just click OK. And since I no longer need my stars, I can select them and press delete. Now I need something to put my stars on, so we're going to create a 3D shape. I'm going to select a fill here, and I'm going to use a really dark blue fill color. Maybe something even a little bit darker than this. And I'm going to draw out a circle, so I'll go to the ellipse tool, hold the shift key as I drag out a circle. Now I only need half a circle for my 3D effect, so I'm going to the direct selection tool. I'm just going to select over this anchor point here and press delete. So now I have a semicircle. With it selected, I'll choose Effect and then 3D and then Revolve. I'm going to turn Preview on because I need to see what's happening here. And my revolve has not worked out exactly the way I wanted. I wanted a sphere and I've got a sort of cylinder. Well, the reason for this is this setting here. At the moment, it's rotating from its left edge. I want it to rotate from its rightmost edge. And this gives me what I expected to see. I can choose plastic shading or diffuse shading. You can choose whichever you like. And then you can alter your light source if you wish. So I want a light source that's sort of coming in from over here for now. If you don't see all of these options here, you'll just click your More Options button. And then you need to go to Map Art. Now this shape here only has one surface, and this is what its surface looks like. And if we want to map our art to it, we can just drop down this list, and this is a preview of all the symbols available in this document. And since we made our stars into a symbol, then we can use the stars to map onto our 3D art. Now at the moment the stars are smaller than the mappable area, so I'm just going to click Scale to Fit. And I'm going to make sure that this doesn't give me stars that are distorted in any way. If they were, I could drag this out to make them taller or shorter or wider. But it's looking pretty good with scale to fit. So I'm just going to click OK. Now at this point, I could also rotate this shape. At the moment, it's an off-axis front setting, but you can choose any of these options. So you could choose isometric left, or you could choose off-axis back, or you can even rotate the shape yourself. So you could rotate it around and see which area of the shape you wanted to see. And when you let go, the art is mapped onto the 3D shape. At this point, you could also go ahead and adjust the light source. You can add additional light sources as well. So I might want some extra light here, so I'm just going to add a second light source. When I'm happy, I'll just click OK. Now the way that Illustrator works is that this is just a 3D effect applied to my shape. So if I select my shape and go to the Appearance panel, you'll see that there's an entry for the 3D Revolve with the map artwork. If I turn off the eyeball icon here, this is the shape, and this is just an effect applied to our shape. Let's have a look at another possibility for our 3D shapes. I'm going to select the rectangle tool. I'm going to just drag out a long, narrow rectangle. And up here in the shape's dimensions, I'm just going to set its height to a known value. So I'm going to set it to 25 pixels because that's going to make my mathematics a little bit easier. I'll select the shape, hold down the Alt or Option key and drag a duplicate shape away. And this one I'm going to color white. So together these two shapes are 50 pixels in height. I'm going to choose Effect and then Distort and Transform and Transform because this is an easy way of creating a stripe pattern. I'm going to add about 10 copies and I'm just going to move these vertically 50 pixels because that's the height of the combined shapes. And here are my stripes. So I'll click OK. I'm going to choose Object Expand Appearance to expand these and I'm going to choose Object Ungroup and continue to do that until Ungroup is no longer an option. At which point I'll just choose Group to group them into a single object. And of course now we need to add them as a symbol. So I'll just click here on New Symbol, I'll call this Stripes and just click OK. And since I don't need the stripes any longer, I'll just select them and delete them. Now I'm ready to create a shape and for this I'm just going to use the pen tool. I have a sort of blue color selected. You'll need a color just so you can see what you're doing. I'm going to click and drag in a sort of upwards direction and then come over here and click and drag in a sort of downwards direction. It's this sort of curve that I want. I'll press escape to finish drawing the shape. With the shape selected, I'm going to choose Effect and then 3D and then Revolve. And I'm going to click Preview On. And this is the sort of shape that I want, a sort of cone shape. Now, I can vary it a little bit if I want by just tipping it over. This shape might be a little bit difficult to fill, so we'll just see how we go. I'm going to click on Map Art, and I'm told that there are now three surfaces for this. Each of these surfaces is a little bit different to the others. So I'm going to select the first surface and click Stripes, and I'll scale them to fit. And that's going on this area of the cone. Let's go forward to the next surface and again apply our stripes to it, and again scale it to fit. You can see that Illustrator has split this into two pieces. So there's this piece and then the next piece that we're going to be mapping to is this outside piece. So you can see it is a little bit of an inexact science. But let's go ahead and apply our stripes to the last surface. And again, we'll scale to fit. Now, because we've got two surfaces here and one is quite narrow, these stripes have ended up being really close together. Well, we can solve that by just stretching them so that they better match the other stripes in this shape. I'm a little bit concerned at the join here, so I want to make sure that I've got a good result here. And you can always come back to the previous surface and just adjust that a little bit as well, until you see something that looks pretty seamless, and then click OK. At this point, I'm going to be very reluctant to reshape my shape because it's going to be too easy to lose this design. So I'll just click OK. And again, I can move this shape out of the way and we can have a look and see what we've got. You'll find that there's a lot of fun to be had in creating shapes and revolving them and then mapping your art to those shapes. It's a fairly easy process and shapes like the sphere are going to give you really good results. Other shapes are a little bit more challenging. I hope that you've enjoyed learning this Illustrator technique for mapping art onto 3D surfaces. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.